Welcome, everyone. My name is Dana Brown, and I am Zojo's Marketing Director. In this tutorial, we are going to see how to create temporary files. So that means files that are automatically deleted once we don't need them anymore. And these files are out of scope, meaning that they'll be deleted when we don't keep any references to them. So in order to use these temporary files, we start creating a new class, which has been named Temp Folder Item. And as you can see, the class is composed simply by a property set with a folder item data type, and that will be in charge of keeping a reference to the original folder item created by us in code. We also need to implement a constructor that receives the folder item as a parameter and assigns it to the property, and also the destructor that will be in charge of deleting the folder item itself once the class instance is out of scope. So we can see that this class acts as a wrapper around a folder item instance, but I want to focus on these two overloaded methods for the operator convert. So what's an operator convert method? This method called in a class in order to convert a data type into another one. So it's really convenient. For example, it is really convenient when we need to assign an instance of a data type that is not the same that the one from the class itself is. So in this example, we've overloaded the operator convert method, so it returns a folder item instance from our temp folder item data type. And in the case of this second overloaded method, we receive a folder item, so we can assign it to our class property when we use code in something like my temp folder item equals my folder item. In the case the overloaded method gets into play, assigning the assigned folder item to the property so it can be handled by our class. In this fragment of code, we can see a use case for our class. Here we have an F property declared as temp folder item, and it is in the open event where we're going to create a new temp folder item instance, making use of the constructor. So it takes a regular folder item as the argument pointing to the test.txt file in the computer desktop. So the temp folder item is created and its reference stored in the F property under the by default window 1 window. And that property will be in scope, which means in memory, as long as the window 1 remains open. Once we close the window 1 window, the F property will be out of scope, so it will be deleted from memory. So it will execute its destructor method, and it will be here when the reference folder item is deleted. So if the reference folder item is not nil, and it exists, which means that it has a data in the file itself, then we simply call the remove method on that file, and that's all. As you can see, this implementation has been done, so it only works with files and not folders. So it won't delete any of the referenced folders, for example. We can now see how this works running in this little demo app. So let's run the app. And once it opens the window, it will create a new file in the desktop as it did when we reviewed the code in the open event. Remember that we can create a temp folder item instance stored in the F property. And then we open a text output stream to write some data to it. So here you can see the just created file in the path specified by us in code, whose content is the one written by the text output stream. Then, as soon as we close the window, the file will be deleted thanks to the destructor method from our temp folder item instance. So that's something we don't need to take care of anymore. Obviously, you can change and improve this class behavior so it can take care of other cases related, for example, when deleting a reference folder. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Twitter and Facebook. Also, visit our blog and the forum to read about the latest news and keep learning about Sojo.